Oh, yeah.
Where's your doggy? Say, doggy?
Well, I know the youngsters of this city.
You always want what you don't have.
So why shouldn't he do it?
Right.
Well, it's thick, but...
Oh, I still don't know.
Oh, just surprised me. I was expecting to come over after work, man.
Wednesday, cloudy, chance of snow.
Or record over it, you know, use a different tape to send me the show, but...
We are coming to get our check.
The objective of the game is to become the wealthiest player in the game through buying, renting, and selling property.
Wife sucked dick. And then tried to accuse me of being a snitch. That nigga is goofy. And he still owe me money.
And I realized that those videos that I made with more time, loaded with more information, with more data, very educative, educational, however you want to call it, that I thought they are very essential for artists to know before becoming an artist entrepreneur. And those videos received very little views, and they're not so influential. On the contrary, those videos that I spend very little time talking about current affairs, trending topics, and those videos are the ones who got away pretty fast, and they got more engagement, more click-through rates, and more impressions overall, that they perform better.
At the very same time that America refused to give the Negro any land, through an act of Congress, our government was giving away millions of acres of land.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention now to the microphone behind home plate. And please welcome one of America's premier entertainers, Grammy Award winner, Lee Greenwood.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Man, fuck the fucking Diaz brothers. Fuck them all.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, work for all my life.
He says, "Bro, you really short." He says, "You really smoke your cigarettes short." I mean, I don't know. That's, I do think of that though.
Martin Luther King, 20 minutes ago, died.
I saw a man act that I thought I was really. I thought that I was one of the best actors in the world when I was 18, 19 years old, or on the way to being, you know.
In America, symbols of pride and freedom are easily identified. And in Kentucky, there's another black symbol, familiar as one of quality and service. Smith Furniture presents its annual 4th of July sale. GE 25-inch remote control color TV, now only $259. GE large capacity washer, now just $299. There's 0% financing for up to 15 months on Whirlpool appliances, like this 22-cubic-foot refrigerator with door dispenser. Menards, Smith Furniture, appliance and electronics. That too, sale ends 4th of July.
He used you, G.
It occurred to me, having watched MTV over the last few months, that it's a solid enterprise, and it's got a lot going for it. I'm just floored by the fact that there's so few black artists featured on it. Why is that?
Now save big time during the big time sales event going on now at your Northern California Ford store. This 4th of July, get the season's biggest savings, like low 1.9 financing on...
You're insecure and you're scared. You're scared. You're insecure. You're insecure, that's why. You're insecure, that's why. You're scared.
There's a paradox that is stumping psychologists right now, and it's this. Over the past 50 years, despite the standard of living rising dramatically in the Western world, happiness has stayed level, while mental illnesses, anxiety disorders, narcissism, and depression have all gone up.
And it's always pounding at the walls. It's these little guys, these little heathens with no soul downstairs with horns on their head with a battering ram.
All right, well, the death of Robin Williams is raising awareness about depression and suicide. So
join I'll tell you what made me delete my Instagram account in a minute. Why do you think I don't like being beautiful?
A small memorial has started to grow outside this store in Manhattan. Kate Spade no longer had a financial statement.
Lifestyles of the rich and famous. Meet the stars of show business and big business. Discover how life's winners live, love, and spend their fortunes. Enter their dazzling world of luxury on privileged tours of the fantasy palaces they call home.
Entertainment, what distinguishes it, is that it happens within what we already know. Whatever our reaction, laughing, crying, getting excited, underneath it, entertainment says, yep, the world is the way you think it is. And that feels great. Man, I love having highly skilled people or great technology or cool, interesting things confirming my sense of the way things are. Fantastic, worth big money. What distinguishes art is that it happens outside of what we already know.
Blast your ass away. Why don't people listen, man? Like, I be trying to hurt them or some shit like that. I ain't trying to hurt you. I want to see you thrive. I want to see you make it. I want to see you do something special with your life. You know, it takes sacrifice, right?
Thank y'all for coming. White power!
Now we're on the day of. Now Jesse done went and told them, look, you better move now.
Reteaching nonviolence.
I'm running out of time.
He had gained the support of 33 heads of African, you know, states. And their agenda was to bring the issue of human rights violations to the Supreme Court at the United Nations. And so he was killed shortly after, as were a few other people.
I want to sing y'all a brand new song I just wrote called Don't Trust Them New Niggas Over There.
Every year, 10 million third world children don't live to see their third birthday, and another 5 million will be gone before their fifth birthday. Those that do live beyond that ripe old age for this part of the world will grow up in dung heaps like this.
They're underfed, they're hungry, their life slowly wasting away because they haven't got enough food.
And I have a recording studio of my own. It has an indoor pool and jacuzzi, and there's horses and the tennis court.
They don't get to make the rules no more. Why should my beauty be dictated by these ugly bitches?
meme that was going around is 4th of July savings explosion. Buy now and save up to 50% on swimming pools of every shape and size.
Miss you, Barneys.
It has been a very, very, very long goodbye. First bankruptcy in August and then the sale in November.
It is a store synonymous with high-end New York shopping, but this morning Barney's is finding itself embroiled in a controversy over race as even more accusations of racial profiling come to light.
Can we all get along? Can we get along?
Shot at the cops who basically are out of control. It's not, you know, when I do this song, I make sure I say, yo, there's some good cops out there, you know. I ain't gonna lie. But there's cops out there that are using their badge to fill up their insecurities that they've had ever since they were a little punk kid, and they became a cop just in order to do that. And they take those badges and they try to play God with them, you know. Cops don't go to jail for murder, we do, you know. They get laid off.
I've been in fear of the cops for ever since I can remember.
I want you to, for a moment, think about playing a game of Monopoly. Except in this game, that combination of skill, talent, and luck that help earn you success in games as in life has been rendered irrelevant because this game's been rigged.
I'm kind of like Trump. I think the media, overall media, not every media, you might not be too
I'm a
bad
nice guy.
You might really
We're
be
nice
bad.
People.
I don't know whether you're bad or good. We have a media that is absolutely at war with the white people of this country.
I don't really, honestly, deep down believe in political action. I think the system contracts and expands as it wants to. It accommodates these changes. I think the civil rights movement was an accommodation on the part of those who own the country.
Senate Republicans condemn David Duke, the KKK, and his racism.
Nigga, 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 nigga.
At Tom Peterson's, our biggest 4th of July sale
Word
ever.
Nigger.
Save as never before.
My
Your
then
choice,
8-year-old approached me and asked,
buy the Samuel
Daddy?
D. recorder. Only 188.
What's a racist?
Fuck the Diaz brothers.
How often have you fantasized about being rich and famous? It's certainly a lifestyle that few really get to enjoy. Even though we all can live it, we can now all get a close-up look at just how the rich and famous really live, thanks to Robin Leach and his television crews and the production of the weekly series, Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous, which are seen on 170 stations, many of these independent stations that are on the line today. Robin, it's good to see you.
It's good to be with you, Marvin.
You are such a busy man. I called you 3 times in the last month and a half. Once your secretary said you were in London, the next time you were in Rio, and the next time in California.
It sounds grand, but we are actually traveling about 75,000 miles for each 1 hour of television that we show.
You show no signs of any jet lag today.
No, I can sleep on planes, fortunately.
What do you find a common thread between the rich and famous who you've interviewed for your program?
Yeah, I find that although money doesn't buy happiness, it sure does help. I've yet to meet an unhappy millionaire.
But you don't do this. I know you're thinking, oh, bad. Just throw it out the window. And nobody's going to get hurt.
New York City is the safest big city in the country because of NYPD officers.
Hillbilly Elegy. But it, I think among
order.
All else, it's a personal story. It's about growing up in Appalachia under what I think what
so
everybody
what is
would agree
it
difficult
that
circumstances
so many white
raised by your grandparents.
There are days when solitude is heady wine that intoxicates you. Others when it is a bitter tonic. And still others when it is a poison that makes you beat your head against a wall.
I'm part of the problem. Because I don't know how to solve the problem, and so what do? I ignore it.
You is kind, you is smart, you is important. You is smart, you is kind, you is important.
Well, I don't
your own pearl. No one knows you don't pay colors enough to afford pearls.
Cobra Raven.
And I work like a dog.
From the Cobra Raven. Two jet engines.
Living off a coffee from a pot. None of you want to touch.
The lecture of fear goes something like this. All people are afraid. Being afraid is a very normal, healthy thing. If an individual were not afraid, I would have to send them to a psychiatrist to find out what was wrong. Nature gave us fear in order to survive. And of course, fear is our best friend. Without fear, we would all die. We'd do something foolish or stupid, which would cause our death or being crippled. Fear is something which has to be controlled. I always compare it to fire. Fear, like fire, must be controlled. And once it gets out of control, like fire, it can destroy everything around.
Don't you want to be champion? You could be champion of the world. And I didn't pay no attention to it. He said, really? You could be champion of the world. You could devastate the world. No man could take what you did. You just got to believe it. I looked at this guy, and then I started thinking. I said, you really? I said, this guy's really crazy. That's what I said, this guy's crazy. He said, you do what I tell you to do, and if it doesn't work, then you could leave. So I said, okay, bet. So I did everything he told me to do, and I won. I won every championship from the amateur championship. Oh, I won all the championships. I'm gonna cry.
Did you know you're special? It's true. Each and every one of us is special in our own way.
But the fact of the matter is there are rules for having discussions, for thinking, for making your case, presenting arguments. And
you know when you
say violate
yourself,
some of these
you know
rules,
what you've got to do, right?
We have the capacity. We have these tools that say, hey, wait a minute, hang on. No, you can't quite
do that.
Get away with that on, unless you do some more work here.
This white immigrant can come to this country 50 years ago with a nickel and dime and no education.
And I still
and come here and pool their little nickels and dimes and no education. And set up little stores, develop these stores into larger stores, develop this into an industry which creates job opportunities for whites. Since Lincoln was supposed to have freed the black man 100 years ago, and today the black man, according to the government economist, has spending power of $20 billion per year. We feel that with the black man spending $20 billion a year, not setting up any businesses, not creating any industry, not creating any job opportunities for his own kind, he's not in a moral position to point the finger today at the white man and tell the white man that he's discriminating against him for not giving him a job in factories that he himself set up. If the black man has $20 billion, and these so-called Negro leaders are such geniuses that they can integrate white restaurants and integrate white factories and integrate, force themselves into that which the white man has set up, they should use this same ingenuity to show the black people how to pool our wealth and set up something of our own. And then we won't have to force our way into his anymore. One more thing I would like to point out concerning what he said about 125th Street. We don't waste our time on 125th Street. But you can reach more people.
I'm coming to you here in my truck today. I got a Ford F-150.
Bourgeoisie society,
yeah,
bourgeoisie church, and the bourgeoisie
service.
We, our program is directed toward the man in the street. So we spend
many years I was a racist.
And what we do with that man, instead of change the whiteness
in word
and your mind, make you accept
and
us, we change
I come
the mind of the black man and make him accept himself. And as soon as he accepts himself, he'll solve his own problem. He won't be trying to force himself into your factory and into your bedroom and into your kitchen.